Mariam children, today I'll show you one practical. I'll show you in physics, that is how to take reading in a vernier caliper. In vernier caliper, we can measure the external diameter of a hollow cylinder, the internal diameter of a hollow cylinder, or the diameter of a spherical bob, or the height of a beaker. So today I'll show you how to take reading. I'll measure the diameter of a spherical bob. Many times children have the problem that they cannot understand how to take reading in a vernier caliper. They always have the problem that is very difficult to understand. Now after my explanation, definitely you will say that it's now very easy to take the reading in a vernier caliper. So let's see how I am doing. So children, this is a vernier caliper. In this vernier caliper, there are two scales. This is the main scale, which is fixed, and this is the vernier scale, which is movable. This one is movable, vernier scale, but the main scale is fixed. Now, in this vernier caliper, we can measure. This is called the lower jaws, this is called upper jaws, and this one is called your string. If we'll extend this one, we can also extend this one like this. So, in lower jaws, we can measure the diameter of a spherical bob, or the external diameter we can measure. And with this upper jaw, what we'll do? With this upper jaw, we can measure the internal diameter. Suppose this is a beaker. We have to fix like this here, and we can measure the internal diameter of this beaker. Clear? And this strip is used to measure the height of the beaker. Suppose we have to extend this strip up to the end, we have to put the strip and see up to here, we can measure the height by putting the beaker like this. So how we can measure? I will take the reading, now I'll show you. So here in this main scale, there are 0 to 15 centimeter, there the readings. Now it is 0, 1, so 1, 2, 3 like this, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter like this given. So in 1 centimeter there are 10 divisions. In 1 centimeter there are 10 divisions. So you know that 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So 1 division in the main scale is 1 millimeter. That means this is the length. This is 1 division from 0 to 1. This is 1 division. So this length is 1 millimeter. Like this 10 divisions are there. So when 10 divisions will complete here, this is 1 centimeter. So 1 division on the main scale is 1 millimeter. Then the number of divisions on the vernier scale is 10. So total number of divisions on the vernier scale is 10. So least count, how to find? Least count means the least measurement we can measure with this vernier caliper. Least means the lowest measurement we can take from this vernier caliper. So lowest measurement, how to measure? So least count is equal to 1 division on the main scale by divided by total number of division on the vernier scale. 1 main scale division divided by total number of division on the vernier scale. So here I am writing. So least count is equal to 1 division on the main scale, what we got, 1 millimeter, divided by total number of division on vernier scale, I have told you 10. So it is equal to 0.1 millimeter. We can convert it into centimeter. So if we will convert into centimeter, it will be divided by 10. So 0.01 centimeter. So least count you got, 1 division on the main scale is 1 millimeter, but divided by total division on the vernier scale is 10. So 1 by 10 is 0.1 millimeter. If we'll convert into centimeter, it will be 0.01 centimeter. Clear? Now we have to see next step is to how to calculate or how to check zero error is there or not. To see the zero error in this instrument, what we have to do? We have to bring the two jaws close to each other. Like this, it is free. Now, here it is free. Now, to see there is zero error there or not, we have to bring the two jaws close to each other. After that, this is the zero division of the vernier scale and this is the zero division of the main scale. When this zero division of the vernier scale coincides with the zero division of the main scale, then we can say the instrument is free from zero error. Coinciding means in a straight line. So the instrument is free from zero error. In my instrument, there is no zero error because zero division of the vernier scale coinciding with the zero division of the main scale. If suppose in your instrument, when you will do practical, in your instrument, this zero division lies to the right side. This is the zero division of the main scale and this is the left side and this is the right, this is the right side and this is the left side. So, if this zero division of the vernier scale lies to the right side of the zero division of the main scale, then that is called positive zero error. If this zero division lies to the left side of the zero division of the main scale, then that is called negative zero error. So, how to calculate? In my instrument, there is no error, no zero error. But if you have in your instrument have the error, may be positive, may be negative, then how to calculate? What is the formula? So I am writing here. So zero error there are two types of zero error. One is positive zero error. To calculate the positive zero error, the formula is, here before that we have to give plus sign. If it is positive means you have to give plus sign. And within the bracket, we have to write BC into LC. BC into LC means what? BC is vernier coincidence and LC is least count. Already we have calculated least count from here and BC how to calculate. Now I'll tell you. Then if negative zero error is there, negative zero error, then we have to give minus sign and we have to total number of division on the main scale is 10 minus BC into LC. So here directly vernier coincidence into least count, here if negative zero error, minus sign you have to give, 10 minus vernier coincidence into least count. 10 is, why you have written 10? Because total number of division on the vernier scale is 10. So 10 minus BC into LC. So BC how to calculate? In my instrument, there is no zero error. But suppose in your instrument have the zero error, so how to calculate the BC? So see here. So see how to calculate vernier coincidence. To calculate the vernier coincidence, you see between this 10 division, any division which is coinciding with the main scale division, any division, maybe 1, maybe 2, maybe 3, maybe 4, maybe 5, like this. Any division which coinciding with the main scale division, that is the vernier coincidence. That's why it is called vernier coincidence, coinciding. So vernier coincidence, you have to check here which is in a straight line with the main scale. I am not calculating because I have no zero error. But in your instrument, if you have the zero error, then you have to calculate the vernier coincidence. So how to calculate vernier coincidence understood? Any division of the vernier scale which is coinciding with the main scale, that is the vernier coincidence. So vernier coincidence always in the number form, not in decimal. Understood? Maybe 1, maybe 2, maybe 3, or maybe 4, 5, anything. Clear? Out of 10 means within 10 any number it will come. It never it will come in decimal number. Many times children doing the mistake in decimal number they are writing. Never it will come 1 year coincidence in decimal number. Understood? What is 1 year coincidence? Now we have to take the reading. So before taking the reading, we have to now I will measure the diameter of this spherical bob. Now I have to fix this spherical bob in between the two jars. See how I am fixing here. Here we have to keep and fix it. I have put here and fixed here. Clear? Now we have to take the reading. First we have to take the measure the main scale reading. This is the main scale. So main scale reading, what is the reading? We have to check it. So main scale reading, how will check? Here this is the zero division of the vernier scale. Up to zero division of the vernier scale, what is the reading that we have to measure? Understood? Fix it properly. Now up to zero division of the vernier scale, what is the reading on the main scale? That is the main scale reading, or shortly it is written as MSR. So here you see, this is the division, zero division coinciding with the main scale division. So what is the reading you see? Up to here there is 2 cm. That means from here 0 to 2, here 10 division, 10 millimeter, here another 10, 20. Then here you see 1, 2, 3, 4. So here 4 division, so total is 24 division. That means 24 millimeter. So in centimeter, what to write? 2.4 centimeter. So MSR will be 2.4 centimeter. Now I am writing here. So I will make a table here. Simply just write it, MSR in centimeter. Here we can write in centimeter. Clear? And next column is here, VSR in centimeter. So VSR means your vernier scale reading, and MSR is main scale reading. Just I have taken the reading, main scale reading. Then next we have to calculate the VSR, vernier scale reading, whose formula is VC into LC. The same formula here. In positive zero error, VC into LC. Here also same formula, VC into LC. But the difference is that here vernier coincidence we are calculating by bringing the two jaws close each other. But here vernier coincidence will take by fixing the bob in between the two jaws. Now I'll show you how to measure the vernier coincidence. So the formula here is VC into LC. Clear? What is the formula? VC into LC. So VSR is equal to VC into LC. Then the last column, we have to add both MSR and VSR. So MSR plus VSR in centimeter. Clear? Now we'll take the reading. MSR already got. How much you got? 2.4. 2.4 centimeter you got MSR. Now how to calculate VSR? Now we'll measure VSR. So VSR is vernier scale reading. So in vernier scale reading formula I have written VC into LC. So VC is the vernier coincidence. Here how to measure the VC in VSR? In VC here you have to calculate by fixing the bob here. We have to see which division is coinciding with the main scale. We have to here one division, this is another division. So which division perfectly coinciding with the main scale? Any division it will coincide, no problem. So I am seeing here which division is coinciding. Suppose 6th division it is coinciding. So the vernier coincidence is here 6, and the least count already you got. So we can measure now the VSR. So I am writing here. So VSR, VC into LC, VC you got 6
into LC 0.01, so it is equal to 0.06. So MSR plus BSR now will add 2.4 plus 0.06. It is equal to here 2.46. Got the MSR plus BSR. So like this, in one reading also we will get the diameter, but to get the accurate reading, like these three observations we have to take. This is one observation, another observation will take, like this three observations we have to take, and after that we add all the observations, then we have to take the average so that the accurate reading will get. So next reading I am taking. So next reading, similarly we have to put the bob here to fix it. Just in the second case, what we'll do, we'll take out the bob and just rotate it again, you fix it again, just change the position, just you fix it. So again you see the main scale reading is same 2.4. so always remember, as it is spherical shape, the main scale reading always it will come same. So your main scale reading is 2.4 centimeter. Now the vernier coincidence we have to see. Vernier coincidence, this time it is coming, vernier coincidence will change. So vernier coincidence, it is coming, which division is coinciding? Your 7th division is coinciding. So I am writing here. So second reading you got the MSR 2.4, and here the vernier coincidence you got 7 into 0.01, it will be 0.07, and you add both 2.4 plus 0.07, it will be 2.47. clear? 2.47. now we'll take the third reading. In third reading also we'll take out the bob, again you have to rotate and fix it. You see, the every case is the MSR is coming same, because it is a spherical shape, so it will MSR, it will not change, it will come same 2.4 centimeter. Now you have to see what is the vernier coincidence. Vernier coincidence here, this time which division is coinciding with the main scale division? This is 5th division is coinciding. So I am writing here the vernier coincidence is 5 and main scale reading 2.4. So I am writing here, so main scale reading 2.4, and here the vernier coincidence is 5th division coinciding, so 5 into 0.01 least count, 0.05, so we'll add it, we'll get 2.4 plus 0.05, so it will be 2.45. so all the three readings you got. Now we have to add all the three readings and the average we have to take, so that we'll get the observed diameter. So I am adding here. So the observed reading or observed diameter, observed diameter, you have to add all the three and divide it by 3. That means we have to take the average 2.46 plus 2.47 plus 2.45 divided by 3. We'll get 2. If we'll add 7 plus 5, 12 plus 6, 8, 18. So I'm gone. Then 4 plus 4, 8 plus 4, 12, 13. 3 decimal point put. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6. And then 1, 7. So 7.38 divided by 3. So if we'll divide, we'll get 3 to the 6, 2.46. So we'll get 2.46 the observed diameter. 2.46 centimeter, this is the observed diameter. If there will be zero error, then we have to, there are two types of zero error I have told you. positive zero error and negative zero error. If positive zero error there, then from this observed diameter we have to subtract the positive zero error. If negative zero error is there, then with this observed diameter we have to add the negative zero error, what we'll get. But in my instrument there is no zero error, there is no zero error. So this observed diameter is my correct diameter. Is 2.46 centimeter. If we'll round up, we can write 2.5 centimeter. Understood? Just round up. So is equal to not there. Just the symbol of round up give you like this. So this is 2.5 centimeter. So we'll get the correct diameter is 2.5 centimeter. So understood how to take the reading in a vernier caliper? Clear? So thank you.